cost and care of Cincinnati's fleet is getting renewed attention tonight.
Now, we're not talking about the city's police cruisers, the garbage trucks, the recreation vehicles. We're talking about the cars city workers take home at the end of the day, cars you pay for with your taxes. News John London is live with the facts and figures about our fleet. John?
Yeah, Jack, the city's internal auditor says Cincinnati's entire fleet is about to get a top-to-bottom audit with an eye towards determining if the cost of repair and maintenance of the fleet is justified, if it's properly sized, and if those who are taking city cars home should be taking city cars home. Keeping the city fleet rolling is a $12 to $15 million yearly undertaking. Critics contend the bang for the city's buck sounds more like a bust.
In the private sector, people are just happy to have a job. Not everyone gets mileage just driving to and from their home to work. I mean, that's absurd. That's a relic of an old union-based era.
Here's part of Birding's overall point about how the city spends. The city bought a police motorcycle for $16,000 8 years ago. To date, the city spent nearly $55,000 to repair and maintain it. Records show an employee who's logged 5,524 miles with a take-home car has driven all but four going to and from work.
The point's well made.
Late this afternoon, the city's auditor and fleet services manager were quizzed about the expenses and the justification for the 132 taxpayer-supported take-home cars. 68, the bulk of them, are used by the police department. Looking over the breakdown today, Firefighters Union President Mark Monahan says their number has gone down.
I mean, I know the fire department takes a good hard look at the fleet all the time. We have limited budgetary dollars as it is.
The city annually buys more than 2 million gallons of fuel. Take-home cars fill up at city pumps. The fleet services budget has been cut by $1.6 million, so it's spending more just to maintain as opposed to replace. Birding wants to slice the take-home number by half.
Maybe we can use that money to not lay people off or keep the swimming pools open.
And tonight, Assistant City Manager Scott Stiles says all this merits a review, which strikes FOP President Kathy Harrell as somewhat ironic because she says that City Council has been well aware of this issue for a long time and could have had a cost savings in the 2009 and 2010 budgets when she brought all this up during those budget discussions. Live at City Hall, John London, News 5.